Hello everyone, welcome back to the Footyballs channel. Today let's show you something really, really cool. Now, a couple of videos back I did the flute video with Milan and I showed you my mixer chain right here. Me cool. Yeah, and it instantly makes everything sound nice, so you could call it Soundgoodizer 2.0, but yeah, Soundgoodizer is in there, but it's disabled. And every other plugin, yeah, it's basically third party Fab Filter replica for Hollow Room. A lot of people don't have these plugins, so yeah, I could share this one, but what's the point if you can't open half of it? So I did some really interesting stuff. Now the most important thing in this chain is the compressor, I think. And as you can see, there's basically one knob, because this one, the gain, is just a volume knob, volume booster. But yeah, this is basically a preset compressor. You could see it like that. It does have an attack and a release and all that stuff, but you can't see it. So I had to measure it out, and I did that with Oxford. I don't know why. And after that, I matched those settings. Here it comes in FL Studio. So here's Fruity's chain. Yeah, it's a free download. You can download it right now. But before we dive into it, let's show you how it sounds. So in the free download, there's one of my samples included, one you might not have used a lot, but it's actually really great. So let's go to the flute right here. So this is a beer bottle. Of course it is. So how can you possibly use this, right? So let's play some stuff. Yeah, that's really terrible. So let's loop it right here. So that's way better. So yeah, it's starting to sound great. Now let's match it up a bit so it looks a bit flatter. And now let's change the start time. Okay, so that's cool. Let's go to a high note to see if it loops. Now, it's not perfect, but it doesn't have to be perfect. Now, let's do the cool stuff. Let's throw it to Fruity's chain. Now, this is without, and this is with. So it sounds really different, right? Now, of course, the volume is a bit louder. So when you use this, I renamed everything actually, but I can't see the new name. So the bottom EQ is volume compensation. But you can still hear it sounds really nice. And in case you want to have it way more stereo, enable the stereo shaper. It's basically the replacement for my dimension expander from Serum. So yeah. And you can make it a bit dirty like this. Right here. So I think this really sounds cool. So this sample and this chain is included in the free download below. You can download it right now and have some fun with it. And it's all FL Studio stock, so yeah, you can use it. Now, before we continue, let's make this sound a bit cooler. Now it has more punch. Okay, sounds nice. Let's disable the reverb for now because it's getting annoying. Now, even with delay, reverb and volume compensation, there's still a big difference. That's because of the low cut right here, for types of sound like leads and plugs. And the compressor makes it more punchy. Now this took me a lot of minutes and hours to fine tune. But this is basically the CLA 3A by Waves. And I tweaked it a little bit. So yeah, and this is an exciter, a bit more low because there's a low cut. Okay, why did I do that? Never mind, a bit more high so it sounds fresher. Now let's turn this into a plucky sound, because I really want to show you the capabilities of this beer bottle sound. Okay, So let's go over here, volume, and let's throw the attack down, sustain down, and decay, hold, way. Okay. Like this. More decay. Alright, so let's enable these again. Okay, so I think this is a really useful sound. Now the stereo shaper right here, don't use it on your main sounds because I've noticed it makes it less mono compatible, which means when you play it on one speaker, it'll be not as loud as on two speakers, phasing and stuff, phase cancellation. But when you are using this for chords or background sounds, you can use it. Otherwise than that, it's fine and it might sound cool. But yeah, Fruity's Chain. This is without, and this is with. More punchy, more fresh, more stereo, and free. So have fun. Now, other stuff. So now another thing. Yesterday I've been working on something new. Well, it's not really new, but it's the Fruity Monsters bundle. It's the Essential Sample Pack, the Serum Bank, old version and new version, and the Silent One Bank with a few updated sounds. I'm going to show you that in a minute. But yeah, if you haven't checked out any of our stuff yet, I suggest you go for the Producer Bundle. In comparison, it's cheaper, and I think it's some really useful stuff. A couple of years ago, when I had a pack like this, it would be amazing, but of course, there wasn't, so I had to make it myself. Ba-dum, bam, bam, bam. So check out the link below, Fruity Monsters Producer Bundle. This is no new stuff, but it's everything combined and a bit updated, so there's a little bit of new stuff. I also included the original Silent One Bank, the old one. It will work with older versions of Silent One if you haven't updated it yet. And that's in the free download. So make sure to check everything out. There's a description, that kind of stuff. Let's show you some of the new sounds. Okay, so we know this one, but let's go to the kicks because I made some new kicks. Okay, kicks right here, distorted kicks. I also made some new punches. And I'm about to update this kick because I've noticed there's a bit too much bass in there and it could be a bit stereo. It might have some more stereo, but this is also new. I don't know if I told this before, but these are some 200 BPM kicks. I've noticed some people asking me for those kicks I used in higher BPM tracks. And they are very pitchable. Yeah, let's show you quickly how to pitch them. So this is one of those kicks. This is how it sounds. Oh. Yeah, okay, so I usually do this. I make two parts, punch and tail. I make the bottom one unique. Then I go over here. I click declicking mode, generic bleeding. Same for the other one. So it's smooth now. No difference. You cannot hear any difference. Now let's go up right here. 300 cents. And choose your pitching type. I choose mono most of the time. That's basically how I pitch my own kicks. So in a way, there are a lot of kicks in my pack you can play around with. And here are some new ones. And this is my latest one. This was a big project because this one, yeah, this is one of my new favorite kicks I made, and it sounds like this. Now, if you like the tail, if you like the punch, if you like the entire kick, you can all just edit it and cut it away or keep it like this or layer it together, I don't know. And there are 51 kicks in here at the moment, excluding these ones, so more than 51 kicks. I also added a new snare builder. I don't know if there's another name for it, but yeah. I also did a 128 BPM version, and I'm key labeling everything, because yeah, I'll explain it in another video why key labeling is really useful. Now, this is this build-up was inspired by one of the Headhunter's tracks I recently released, and I just listened to how he did his build-up, and I sort of remade it with my own samples. So yeah, and something I also did, there's some sort of pre-sweep here, so the transition to your build-up might seem more natural. Now let's go to Silent One, because I also made some new sounds for Silent One. Preset, bank. So it starts with the init sound. I really like that when I open up Silent, so I can instantly create something. Beautiful. Now, as you can see, there are some new sounds here. 32 saws is a new sound. It's basically a different type of super saw compared to this one. Right here I got some cool bass sounds. Certain doom, yeah. And the funny thing about this preset is when I was making it, I really spent a couple of hours just fine-tuning everything. Just for fun, having a bit of fun with presets making presets. And they started to work with a chainsaw next door. So I couldn't really hear what I was doing, so I had to stop working on it. So I was working with saws and they were working with the saw. So, super saw, yeah! Fucking neighbors. Modulation Nation, I can't really remember this one. Yeah, nice. You hear that delay? Now the delay is disabled, so how did I do this? That's a funny thing. I threw an LFO on the, and I changed it on the second one with a bit more release. So it sounds like delay. If you know where to use it in. Bells of some new bells. And this one is a little bit different. Yeah, I think it's really useful. Now, I've noticed there's something of 1 second of delay between me hitting the keyboard and hearing the sound because I'm recording. I really need to fix that. So I'm trying to figure out a way to record my PC audio with my interface while I'm recording. Somewhere I think it's just a matter of buying cables and plugging them in and changing some settings, but yeah, I really want to get rid of this delay. Now, right here, classic ringtone sound. If you throw in your MIDI in this one, let's find some MIDI. It will instantly sound like an old crappy ringtone. Okay, I don't know. High BPM. Yeah, you can mess around with that. I think it's really nice. It's a really crappy sound. Sometimes we like crappy sounds. Now here, Purple Heart. It's the new track by Headhunters. I know it's Orange Heart. And in case you do have a Purple Heart, I suggest you check out your local doctor. But hey, this is to avoid possible copyright stuff, obviously. And this is the pad I used in my latest Orange Heart remake. I think it's a cool pad. So, this one, I was fooling around a bit and I created this really cool mellotron sound with Silent One. If you play this and don't show the plugin to anyone, I'm not sure if they would recognize Silent One in it. So yeah, I think it really closely resembles the one from Wolf's Cry, Wild Styles and D-Block and Estefan. I really hope I don't mess up titles here. So yeah, those are some of the new sounds. There might be some other ones I didn't show you, but I think this pack, to be honest, it's worth your money. In case you do have Silent One and Serum, but even if you don't, the sample pack is becoming really, really useful, in my opinion. Yeah, so thank you for your support. I'm planning something really cool with some new tutorials, but as I said, I might not have said it, but I'm working really hard to pay the bills here, so that's the reason I'm not uploading every day, but in the future, this will change. So thank you all for your... Oh, crap. So thank you all for your support. Don't forget to check out my flute. Yeah, see you again next time. Thank you for supporting. Thank you for watching. If you got any questions or whatever, just comment. I read every comment people post. And if it's really bad comment, hey, I read that one too. But yeah, we always like the positive ones. So yeah, goodbye.